Hi everyone, welcome to our August What's New in FAQ. For app users, it's the update you've all been waiting for. Our stock library expansion powered by Shutterstock is now live. Plus new and exciting packs for transitions, titles, animated overlays, and stickers. Also, we have a new effect layer feature where you can apply effects such as mosaic, blur, and highlights to your clips.
For PowerDirector 365 users, we've also got a lot of content for you in this month's update, including new packs for transitions, titles, video templates, and more.
Then we round off with our monthly Q&A, where you ask and we answer. And remember to hit the subscribe button and turn on the bell notification to keep up to date with all our videos. Now let's see what's new in this month's update.
For PowerDirector app users, we know you've been waiting for this update for a long time, and it's finally here. We've expanded our Shutterstock library to include millions of royalty-free stock video, photo, and music. Get instant inspiration right within the app as you're creating your project. Simply search for the content you need, download and add it to your project. You can also apply new effect layers to your clips. Use mosaic and blur effect layers to hide private information or make certain parts of the scene stand out with the highlight layer effect. Each effect layer also has customizable settings so you can adjust according to your clips. And that's not all. We know you all love using the stickers in the app. You can easily find stickers using category tabs. Recently downloaded stickers can also be found in the downloaded tab for quick navigation. For new content this month, create an artistic transition between scenes using new glitch transitions, or direct attention to your text with the new colorful titles. If you want to add a bit of summer touch to your videos, try the sun stains and summer animated overlays. To check out these new features and content, update your PowerDirector app to the latest version.
For PowerDirector 365 subscribers, we've got new design packs for you to enjoy. Add smooth dynamic transitions with the Morphing Transitions pack as you jump seamlessly from scene to scene. These practical transitions are perfect for any video project. Or for a fun aesthetic touch, try Geometry Titles pack that includes 20 unique title templates. The Travel Video Templates pack offers 10 scrapbook style video templates if you want to show the world how you vacation in style. These cute video templates make creating home videos and travel vlogs super easy. For more details on new content this month, click here or check out the link in the description box.
Let's start our Q&A sessions with our first question from Chaz X. Are there any templates to do the motion and cam burns effects on mobile? Are there no built-in transitions? Let's see how to create a cam burns effect using the pan and zoom feature in the app. After importing your clip onto the timeline, tap on the edit icon and select pan and zoom. Choose custom to create your own effect. Set the start and end position by moving footage in the preview window. As for built-in transitions in the app, once you have your media on the timeline, you'll see a transition icon appear in between medias. Tap on the icon and find a variety of transitions to use. Then just tap to insert a transition.
The next question is from Art1TV. Is there any function to rotate objects on PC? And yes, there is. Let's go ahead and check out a demonstration in PowerDirector 365. For our example, let's place a shape in our video. Once it's on the timeline, we can directly rotate the object in the preview window, or click on the Designer tab and this will open the Shape Designer. Here we can set up keyframes to customize the rotation path or add ease in and ease out effects.
And last up is a question from Viper Shady Music. How to blur videos in PowerDirector? Blurring objects in video can be useful to add privacy or eliminate distractions. Here's how to add a blur effect on PC and the app. In the PowerDirector app, you can try out our newly released feature that we mentioned at the beginning of this video, called Effect Layer. You can also customize settings such as the intensity or set keyframes. If you're working on a PC, first have your clip on the timeline. Then click on Tools and open up the Motion Tracker. Mark the object you want to blur with the selection box and click Track to start tracking. Click Stop to stop tracking. Next, click the Effect button, and select either Mosaic, Blur, or Gaussian Blur. Adjust the settings if needed, and click OK to save.
And that's it for our What's New and FAQ this month. Let us know below what you think about this month's updates or if you have any questions you want to ask us.
Also, make sure to subscribe to our channel for more editing tutorials and updates. See you guys next time.